All right, people, here we are. We are on the last track of Tickets to My Downfall. What a journey it's been. Roll it. Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Channel's name is The Third Ernest. I'm Ernest Adiano III, y'all guys' third family. If you're new here and you're not subscribing, you like what you see at the end of the video, consider subscribing, clicking bottom right-hand corner. Now, like I said, what a journey we have been on. Who knew that this, we all knew pretty much after hearing the first couple of snippets of songs and first couple of singles he released, but who knew that this album was gonna be this good, this well-rounded, this solid of a punk rock album for MGK when this is his first time, from what I know at least, diving head on into a completely different genre than rap. I don't want to hear no shit about Eminem destroyed his career, that's why he had to switch genres. Nah, if anything, Eminem boosted his career because Hotel Diablo was solid as fuck, and then here we have this album, which again is solid as fuck. And then he like had all eyes on him during the quarantine, and the boy delivered. Like, I don't want to hear nobody in the comments. I don't want to even see a comment that says that Eminem destroyed his rap career, so he decided to go punk rock. Nah, the dude is just that multi-talented to be able to switch genres and pull it off and make it sound like he's just switching genres whenever he wants to. There's no learning curve. There's no like, oh, all right, that was a good first attempt. Nah, this is the first attempt and it's fucking successful all the way through and through. And I'm assuming that this song is gonna be no different, because why would you put the worst song at the very end of the album? The slowest sprinter in a track team isn't the anchor, you know what I'm saying? But I'm excited for this. It's also kind of like a bittersweet moment because this is the first album that I'm doing as like a full-time YouTuber. And this is the first album after I became an MGK fan. And I'm hyped for this song because coming off of that sad ass interlude that we had just heard, this gotta come hard. But that's all that I got to say. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at The Third Ernest, just like the channel. The links are down in the description below. And we got Play This When I'm Gone. Let's get it.
I'm writing you this message just so I could say that I love you. I had to let you know that everything about me was you. Yeah. I think it's time for me to leave, but I'll never leave you. I just looked at your picture, so the last thing I did was see you.
Bro, this is already a dark song. It sounds like suicidal. And I'm sure that that's the intention within the writing for it. And I don't know if he's talking to Megan Fox, especially after that interlude that we just had. I don't know if he's talking to his dad who passed away like recently, right before this. Like, I honestly don't know, but this is dark already. On top of like that very soft plucking of the guitar, and then whatever that sonar echolocation sound in the background is. I can't put my tongue on what it is, but.
I'm 29, my anxiety's eating me alive. I'm fighting with myself and my sobriety every night. And last time I couldn't barely open up my eyes. I apologize. I'm not gonna lie and tell you it's alright.
Yo, this song's progression, like just from that to like the, I guess this is the chorus or maybe this is the pre-chorus, but yo, that progression to go from like darker and then the instrumentation in the background had like it sounds like it has hopefulness in it. I hope this goes where I think it's gonna go, but yo, that the ability for him to acknowledge the fact that nothing is okay, that he has anxiety, that he has mental issues that he has to battle with, he has internal demons, he's battling with sobriety every single night. Like whenever you are truly an addict, not like an addict like you do it socially and you like can't get enough when it's social. I'm talking about like a chemically dependent addict. Your brain chemistry has changed to where you now need whatever chemical you are dependent on, heroin, cocaine, whatever it may be, opiates. Like, it is literally a battle with sobriety, and it's a battle to not give in because your brain is no longer the same as it was before. And I feel like a lot of people don't realize that. They don't realize the seriousness what that is. Addiction and anxiety, both personally, I feel like they're thrown around very lightly. Like, people think that they have anxiety, but really they don't have anxiety. People think that they're depressed or they have OCD when really they don't. It's just they don't have any other term for it. So when people who are actually truly have anxiety disorder or truly truly have like manic depression or truly have chemical addiction where it's affecting their everyday life just to try to fight it and try to keep it away. Like, that's a battle that most people truly will never understand. And like I said in the song Lonely, it's like such a vulnerable thing to put on the record, but I'm glad that he's doing it.
I'm not gonna lie and tell you it's alright. It's alright.
You hear that like bright hopefulness?
You're gonna cry and baby, that's alright. It's alright. I wrote you this song to keep when I'm gone. If you ever feel alone, you're gonna cry and baby, that's alright. It's alright.
Bro, that's like so dark and so light at the same time. It's so hopeful, but also so like, damn, he's at the very end. This sounds like it was written to be listened to after suicide had happened. This has like that Adams feel from Blink 182 feel to it. And that's like, even that song has that same like hopeful energy, but it's like, it's a very sad song deep down. Same thing here, bro. Like, yo, you could either end an album on an extremely high note or you could end the album on an extremely low note, which equates to being a high note. And that's basically what this sounds like. Not everything in life is gonna end up where we're fucking walking away into the sunset together or we wound up victorious. Like, that's not the way real life works. The guy doesn't always get the girl at the end of the movie, and that's okay. Like he said, that like, that's all right. That's the way it goes.
I hope you get to go to all the places that I showed you. When I was on the road and couldn't be home to hold you. Part of me doesn't want this cruel world to know you. So just try and keep in mind everything that I told you. I'm 29 and society's eating me alive. I'm fighting what comes with this notoriety every night. This is the last time I'll ever open up my eyes. I apologize. I'm not
Bro. This song, dog. This one's like hitting me. And I'm not even going through this. Like, if you just put yourself in the shoes of a person who might be battling or who might be having these type of suicidal thoughts. Like, every time that I mention suicide on a video, I link the suicide hotline, at least the United States suicide hotline, in the description below. And this is obviously gonna be no different. This is gonna be above the Patreon link, obviously. But he said, yo, I'm 29 and society is eating me alive. I battle with what comes with this notoriety. And I said that in a past video on this album, like, the notoriety, the fame, like, it's something, again, just like addiction, just like anxiety, is something that most people in the world will never have to deal with. And people want the fame and they want the flashing lights and they want the glory and they want money and everything that comes with this type of notoriety being in the public eye. But it seems like a lot of people who are in this stage, they don't want it. The grass is not greener on the other side. The only thing that's greener on the other side is the money, and you can't take that with you when you go. So what really is there to be had on that side? But yo, that line, this is the last time that I'll ever open up my eyes. I apologize. Like, dog. That's heavy, heavy, heavy.
This is the last time I'll ever open up my eyes. I apologize. I'm not gonna lie and tell you it's alright. It's alright. You're gonna cry and baby, that's alright. It's alright. I wrote you this song to keep when I'm gone. If you ever feel alone, you're gonna cry, and baby, that's alright. It's alright.
Bro, I just realized too that this might not even be to Megan Fox. He might have done the interlude back to back with this song just to make it sound like that, but he could have easily written this to his daughter. I completely forgot that he had a daughter, and yo. Makes it even more heavy. Because let's just say this situation did play out. It's obviously not playing out, but if it did play out, like, she's gonna have those questions for the rest of her life. And this reminds me of the song For Your Eyes Only by J. Cole, in which it's like J. Cole is talking on behalf of his friend who got murdered, or his friend that was in the game because he knew no different. And he's talking to his daughter because that's what his friend wanted. Should he die in the streets? Should he not make it out of that life? And his daughter is too young to understand. Like, make sure that you tell her my story. That's like like this same exact type of song. It's the same song without the middleman. This is Colson talking directly to whoever he's talking to, where obviously J. Cole was talking on behalf of the dead father. But yo, this shit is heavy, son.
It's alright, and I'll miss you.
Bro. And the production decision to like fade it out into nothing. Like saying, I'll miss you over and over, just fading out until there is silence. And there's, that's it. There is that. That's all that there is for the rest of the album is silence because the album is over. There's no song to come and uplift the album anymore. This is the final moment. Just like in the song is basically what he's talking about. The final moments. Yeah. That feeling that I just got right there, it's the same exact feeling that I had when I heard Sing About Me, Crying for Help by Kendrick Lamar off of Good Kid, Mad City. Like that same jarring feeling at the end of every verse when he's talking about like, I'll never fade away, I know my fate and I'm on the ground for this cake, I'ma get it or die, trying to mine every male gender with intentions of buying. You lying to these motherfuckers talking about you can help me with my story, you can help me if you sell this. Like as she's saying that she's never gonna fade away, she's fading away slowly in that verse. And I remember when that hit me for the first time, when I heard it, I was floored, dog. There's very few moments that I can remember, like listening to a song where I got as emotional as I just got right now. I didn't show it on camera, but inside I was like, damn. This song, Sing About Me, For Your Eyes Only, Adam's Song when I was old enough to realize what the song was talking about, One More Light by Linkin Park when Chester Bennington singing, R.I.P. Like, yo, there's very few songs where I can remember this emotion that I had. But yo, this album, we are done with it. And I felt like, and I hope that I did the whole album justice, this album is amazing. Like this is more than I ever could have asked for in this album. I was hoping, like I was wondering, was there gonna be filler? Were there gonna be songs where I was just like, that wasn't really cutting it for me. Nah, this whole album front to back, 1 through 15 is like solid. This shit bangs, son. This is like a 9 out of 10 for me. You know, there's some reactions where I do the reaction and then I don't hear the song ever again, or I don't hear the song again for like 2 months maybe. But this album right here is gonna be in heavy rotation for like the next 3 weeks at least. Yo, Colson, MGK, whatever you wanna be called, bro. Fire, dog, fire. But yo, that brings us to the end of this video and this entire album review. If you like what you saw, please consider liking the video, leaving a comment down below. If you like what you saw enough, please consider subscribing because this long form breakdowns is how I do it around here. Follow your boy on Instagram and on Twitter at @TheThirdErnest. Links are down in the description below. Hit up the Discord, also in the description below. If you want to potentially become a monetary supporter of the channel, because the monetary supporters of the channel are my only source of income right now, because I say it on every single video basically, but my job made me decide between keeping the job and deleting the channel or leaving the job and keeping the channel. And the monetary support that I got basically overnight in the span of like 48, 60 hours maybe, I was able to keep the channel. So that they are the only thing, and the monetary support on Patreon is the only thing that keeps this channel going right now. So if you want to potentially lend a hand and support in that way, you get extra benefits over on Patreon that you do not get on YouTube. But that would and does mean the world to me, to everybody that is subscribed to Patreon. But that's it. That's all that I got to say. Thank you for your time, ladies and gentlemen. And like I always say at the very end of all of my videos, go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. And I'll catch everybody on the next video. Peace.